What I'm holding here is the prototype of the gamma ray spectrometer that our group sent on the MESSENGER mission to Mercury. It is a germanium-based gamma ray spectrometer, so it's a high-resolution gamma ray detector. And the reason that it's gold-plated, that's polished and gold-plated, is this is to act as infrared shielding for the detector, because although this technology is very high resolution, it has the big drawback that to operate, it has to run at minus 200 degrees Celsius, about minus 330 Fahrenheit. So this is especially complicated at Mercury, the closest planet to the sun, because of extremely harsh thermal environment there. And the way you cool the detector in such a harsh thermal environment is first is to have lots of infrared shielding, which reflects the sun's heat and reflects the heat off the coming from the planet. And so a highly polished gold-plated surface reflects about 98% of infrared light. So what we have is an encapsulation with our germanium detector inside, and around it we have several infrared shields, and the whole thing is suspended on a Kevlar set of Kevlar fibers to isolate it mechanically from the outer hot body. We're really getting excited now. The instrument's been in flight for nearly 7 years. Of course, it was very exciting when it launched, but we've just sort of been waiting and we've been off doing other work. So now that it's actually approaching orbit, approaching turn on of the instrument, we're all very excited. We've been having conference calls. We've been reviewing the plans of what we are going to do for testing and evaluation and so on. And so, yeah, it's a pretty exciting time. And we will definitely all rest a little easier once we see the first data coming down. So the purpose of having a gamma ray spectrometer on this NASA mission at Mercury is that the surface of Mercury is highly radioactive. It's bombarded by cosmic rays from space. Unlike Earth, Mercury is not protected from those cosmic rays because it doesn't have a thick atmosphere and it doesn't have a strong magnetic field, both of those things which protect Earth. So Mercury is highly radioactive. So our instrument in orbit can detect those gamma rays, and it turns out that gamma rays act like a fingerprint for the elements that emit them. So if you can measure those gamma rays with high resolution, you can determine the surface composition of the planet. And that's very important to help discriminate between various formation theories to help them understand how the planet formed and what its geological history is.